Good morning. I'm back home, you guys. For those who don't know, I am originally from Rocky Mount, North Carolina, but I was like living there when I was a baby. Then I moved to Franklin County, North Carolina. And I've been through there like maybe 12 going on years. And I moved to Raleigh about 3-4 years ago, Raleigh, North Carolina. So, but I am currently right now in my mom's house in Lewisburg, North Carolina. Shout out to Lewisburg though. I don't know why I'm saying shout out, dude, whatever, but I haven't been here in a while. It's been a minute. To be honest, I'm ready to go home already. Like, last night was rough. Like, leaving the airport with all my bags, the wheelchair assistance, I will say, you're going to need help because you still have to have certain parts of the airport where you have to go and you have to actually just still walk and carry your stuff. And we just had, I had about 2 medicine bags. We all see my bags. I had 2. We had some bags on us, and I just think that it was a little bit much for me and my mom. But shout out to my mom. Shout out to her. As y'all can see, my eyes are a little swollen. And that's because I did have a little moment last night. I had a little moment just thinking about how much she just was there for me. She always has been there for me. But I will say, you need somebody that loves you to help you with this type of process. Yeah, it's all good and stuff like that. But I will say, you need somebody to actually care about you, because this was a lot. I knew it, but when they talk about the mental part about it, yeah, I kind of seen that last night. And my legs are swollen, y'all. I think I was in my feelings because I was a little nervous. And I'm going to talk about that, like, I guess, you know, the whole surgery process. And this is not like you're going to your doctor. These people, the plastic surgery, you know, plastic surgery places, they don't, like, really care about you. Not to say the doctors care about y'all either, you know, but, you know, some good people. You know, it's all about the person, but... Yeah, I mean, some people were caring, but like I say, this is more like a in and out thing, you know, get in there once you're out. But I knew that already, but I'm gonna have different videos where I'm gonna talk about certain things, and that'll be more about the surgery place. If y'all do hear it snoring, that is my dog. I have a bully, his name is Papa, and he's back, and y'all will be meeting him eventually. But yeah, he's been in daycare, and he's back, so he's tired too, y'all. I'm not saying y'all. I look like I just need to go take a shower and get ready for my massage. That's what I look like I need to do. But I need a rest. And also, last night, going through the airport, getting on a plane, I sat on my BBL pillow. And that experience was not as bad, I guess, as I thought it was going to be. I think because I'm short, the fact of me sitting up on something is like kind of comfortable to me. I don't know how to explain that, but it's like, but it did put pressure on my legs, so I don't know. I think that maybe has something to do with my legs swelling, because my legs are very much swollen. That's what I was a little nervous about. And also me putting that type of pressure, I had never really sat on my butt since I came out of surgery. And mind y'all, I am Thursday, Friday, Saturday, 5 days post-op. Today's Monday. I get my first massage today with Blue Heavenly. I'm gonna vlog about that and that experience if I can. And definitely get some type of person with some energy that's caring or can lead me a little bit. Because also, y'all, these boards, these phones, this faja, like, I'm gonna just have to go with the board. I'm gonna have to give y'all more videos, but just the whole process of it is kind of like, I knew it was gonna be, it's kind of, you know, do what you do. You watch YouTube or the doctors and stuff tell you, yeah, I ain't see my doctor. Ain't heard a word from him since I left surgery, which is not really a bad thing. I'm not saying that I couldn't get in contact with him, but I'm just saying, like, it's an in and out thing, you know, like, hey, how you doing? When you're gonna, you know, work on you, we out, you know, you get what you want, you know, we out. What it is, I have, like, different content, and I don't want to keep going into different stuff, but this was just definitely about me, you know. I'm back home, about to have massages back home, and hopefully get a different type of care. I don't know whether I want to stay here or go home. I just think it depends on how I feel. I didn't take any pain meds, and I did just take my pain meds this morning, and I actually feel a little bit lighter. So I'm guessing, you know, I'm not really like just a low pain tolerance person. I mean, I got like a real high tolerance. So I had really been good without Tylenol. And if you see me, everybody was just like, this feels so good. You know, I'm like, oh, I'm such a terrorist. We don't say that. We don't say that at all. No, but yeah, we will get up, and we got to go. We got to get back, right? My dog. And I feel more, I can get more ready at home. I don't know, you know how you just don't feel. Not that I don't feel at home, my mom's. It's just that, you know, you got your bed, your own spot and stuff. And I think I'm gonna go home today. I think maybe I just need to take my pain pills and the Arnica pills, I think, for his thickness, they work. I'm gonna have to order some more of those. But that'll be another video, because that'll be the video where the supplies that did work and the supplies that didn't. So yeah, I'm gonna keep repeating myself, but it's just a little update. Thank y'all. Shout out to Lexus and I. She just literally just text me as I'm saying it. That's crazy. She gonna see this. But yeah. And I got other updates too, about the money situation. Shout out to my auntie Trill. But yeah, I'm gonna get out of this camera because my eyes swollen, eyelashes big, sleepy back. Yeah. So
guess who back? Say what up, Papa. If y'all don't know, y'all know now I have a bully. He's my best friend. So yes, we decided to take that trip home, as you can see. And I basically was just talking and rambling. And if you can see Papa's facial expressions, I do not know if he was doing that on purpose, because he does know a camera is in front of his face. So he's a character. So you never know with him, but he definitely will listen. He's a smart dog. But yeah, I was just basically talking about being healthy before you go into any type of surgery, any type of cosmetic surgery at that, drinking water, exercising, anything basically you would need to do in your daily life, I would advise you to already be doing it. And I just advise that anyway, not just for surgery. And I was just going over that and just talking about the different things that I would do, or I don't think that I'm supposed to be doing, but I really do think that me taking care of myself before was actually a good thing, before making this move. And you know, so before I got in the shower, I did want to show you all the swelling that was in my legs and thighs from that plane ride. And I will say that plane ride was so uncomfortable. That was probably the most swelling I had from this whole surgery in general. And please excuse the little gauze pad. I put that in there for my faja. But yeah, this is just me swole. So right after my shower, I did have a massage appointment, so I was rushing through this. It's not the best way to show me applying my boards and foams, but I'm going to try to go through it as best as I can. I did speed it up as well because it was kind of long. But I'm going to start out with the tank top. I put that on inside out to keep the dyes and linings off of my skin. And also it protects from the faja and all the foams and boards, you know, just rubbing up against your skin and everything. I just put the board, if you need to go back and see that, it was in the very beginning of this clip. The backboard I just put in the back of my faja. Sometimes you can add a foam for more compression. I didn't really do that too much. In the beginning I did. I also had like a triangle piece that went like right under, right beneath my back. Well, not beneath, but right at the lower part of my back and above my butt. Right there in that little dip, it give you kind of like that little mold. But you don't want to wear it for too long because you don't want it to be so deep. So I only wore it for maybe a couple of weeks or so. And I did not wear both of them at the same time. I only wore one or the other. The foams, you want to have three of them, two on the side and one in the front. And I eventually cut my ones on the side so they could fit better to my torso. The size of my the size, you can leave them if you want to. I mean, if you want to keep them all neat and everything, but eventually they're gonna get dingy and you're gonna just want to cut them to make you comfortable. I did have to tighten my faja, well, buckle it all up into the top, and yes, that take hella strength. I'm gonna just tell you right now, you better be knowing to how to hold your breath and have time to breathe, because yeah, it take work. This is my abdominal board. I can't say if I'm actually putting it on upside down or not, because I have watched so many videos and I swear all of them were just putting it upside down and putting it the right way. I don't know. All I know is that I just been wearing it either way. But yeah, so that's about it really. And you have to get it, you have to try to buckle it all the way up to the top. I can't see if I'm on my third row. I think I am. You want to get it as tight as you can. Just know that if you want that third row already, then you will be needing another faja soon. I can't say at this point, this is my like only faja, and I probably got like three more in like the same month or 2 months after. So yeah.
Put on my boards and everything by myself. Whew. My mom's gonna be so proud of me. Yeah, I feel so fresh. Proud of myself. So this is just me showing you all how I put my compression socks on. Yes, it's going to be a little difficult because you have on your boards and you're sore and really can't bend down. But I just rolled mine up through my hand and got all the way to like the little beginning part. And I just slipped them on my foot. And at the end, I basically just started pulling it up on my leg. But I did just wanted to get it over my foot at first because they are thick and they are tight. But yeah, my massage lady, this massage is everything. I feel like my healing process is about to be what I know that it could be. Instead of the stiffness and all the uncomfortableness, like, she about to get me right. And she was talking about my stomach and the compression and stuff, so she really about to help me, I know. I'm going to give y'all more details. I'm going to try to maybe record the next time. But definitely, I'm glad that I came. And that my stomach already looked a little different from the fluid pockets that was already built up. But she did say something about my torso. So I'm going to be switching my backboard. I don't really know. I don't know how I'm going to do my backboard because she said I had a short torso, which I already knew. So I don't know if I'm going to use my little triangle or my one with an indent because I do have a big dent in my back. Not like a dent that, you know, is crazy. It's just how my back is always shaped. Like, I got, like, a hump. But when that natural hump was there. But, yeah, I'm just about to ride and show y'all.
My little man doing so good. He really trying to help me, y'all. He ain't been bad or nothing. His ass a little tired, too. But he really been by my side the whole time. I let him sniff me out. Yeah, I guess he knew something was going on. He been like this the whole time. He ain't been aggy. He ain't been nothing. He just been watching after me, just like that the whole time. Ever since he been here.
Diamonds and tattoos cover my scars.
You can't see them.
New Cadillac bulletproof cost 300 lives.
It's necessary.
Make a killing, it's a crime what I charge.
How much you want?
I got some racks and got the fuck out of Dodge.
So this is a whole new day. It's June the 14th, and I had just left my massage, and I was basically just going over everything that she had talked about, and she gave me a new faja. Well, she didn't give me. I had bought a new faja, and I was just talking about how that faja was getting me right, and yes, it's a Colombian, and I'm going to show more videos and pictures after this clip, but yes, that faja, man, that faja is going to get you right, and I will say that it is tight, and you will not be able to eat all your food, and yeah, just be ready to, like, hold your breath 24 hours a day, because that's what it's just going to feel like. I also was talking about the little, you know, my little girl area down there. Yeah, for the ladies, she will be swole, and she will be, she'll be a little big to be fitting inside of your faja, so yes, if you think you're just clamping your stomach, no, you clamping that down there, because she is going to grow as well. Like, just know, the girl part down there, she get big as hell too. But yeah, so I was also just talking about my massage therapist and what she was saying about my torso. She told me that I do have a short torso, which is basically my body was made to be small. My waist was made to be small. You know, nah, but anyway, yeah, I was just basically just saying, you're going to need to get your massages and eat right and just get your rest and do all of that. And I was just talking about how I'm going to be at home and just chilling and whatever. So, yeah, I was just rambling, to be honest. Okay, so I did tell y'all that I was going to put on my other one. But I was able to get in here. Hold on, let me get this together, make sure she don't come out. It's gauze in there too, y'all. So y'all ain't really about to see anything. But still, just making sure. But, yeah, so I got everything in this faja and I ain't taking it off. I ain't even checked to see if it got a zipper or nothing. No, it don't. So this don't have no zipper or nothing like that. So I gotta take it out to do number two.
This was before I knew how to go to the bathroom or what I was doing, but I'ma just let you know, never have I taken a number two in these fajas. I definitely take them off every time.
First hook, I cut my phones on the side so that therefore they would be more, I guess, better for my size and not be so thick, because she did say my torso is very short. And that made a lot more sense to me. This one on my side a little bit. Let me pull this one up. Hold on, y'all. My bad. Yeah, let me get that one up off my hip a little bit. So, yeah. I got them on my sides. I got one foam under my board. And I did put my gauze under my breast. And I do have these little strips of foam that I just added under here, because it was very much hitting my bone right here, like something just keep, you know, rubbing against it. So I got like more compression right here. My straps I put on the second one. They might can go on the third one, but I just want a little more room. Y'all excuse my arms, like I said, I'm still looking like surgery, feeling like it. And it's the back, y'all. I went ahead, I have my triangle in here, and I did put one in my back too, y'all. That actually feel a little bit more better. I wasn't doing that at first, but I just said let me put it back there and see, because I had started cutting my phones. And yeah, so this is my new faja, and this is what it's doing. I asked her about the compression on my butt and my hips and stuff like that, and I think it's a little compression, but she says also that the butt area has to be a certain way too. She was like, because we don't think about the indents and the cellulite, and she had took classes on that as well, so she wanted me to know that they don't pay attention to that type of stuff until months after. And so she's already getting me ready with the butt and stuff like that. And so just to let you know, I do actually massage my butt a little bit. I rub on it and stuff like that. And she was just like, we're supposed to be like kind of self-massaging ourselves already. So, yeah. Can't breathe. Yeah, she went out of breath. I'm actually okay right now. But like I said, yeah, this is a lot to put on. And mind you, I do wear a tank top. And I have not put on a bra in a couple days. I don't think that's messing up nothing, but I told you I am a little bit more comfortable with just not wearing a bra, because, you know, stuff is sitting a little equal more. But yeah, this is the foams and everything. But I'm about to just chill and relax, and, you know.
Papa, I'm recording you. Stinking butt self. Get my baby on. What you want? Stop. Why are you doing that? What you want? You got booger on your nose. What? Yeah. What's wrong? They still see you. At this point, I wasn't keeping up with the days no more, so I'm just adding clips in, random clips of like my fajas or different things or whatever I was doing.
So, it's me with a regular dress on. I ain't look like nothing in a while. As y'all can see, I'm about to go to my massage. I actually did my eyebrows or whatever. Try to look like something. Arms still look rough, but looking like something. Just about to go try to find a little dress or something, because I gotta go back to work, y'all. But man, this shit take hours.
Shine like you from your first day. You make everything all good. 24/7 birthday.
Guys, my third faja that I just got. I do have a band over my top part, because I am getting a small fluid pocket. Could be seroma. It's not infected or anything. I need more compression at my top, because these fajas, I'm telling you, you need more than two. Obviously, this is my third one, but they get big like fast. And I don't know, my body's also just doing real good, so. They're getting real small in the waist, but I have hips and I have butt, as you can see, and it's not supposed to have any compression on it. So my thing is that my waist is getting a lot smaller, but my hips and butt need to stay the same. So it's kind of getting a little tough with picking out a faja. This is a large, so and I'm already on the second one, so I'm gonna give this a little time, and I'm pretty sure I'll be needing to get it taken in or get it smaller. Well, basically same thing, I'm sorry. But yeah, I got my other two. I just dropped them off to get them taken in. Sorry, y'all, I wore a bra once, probably since I've been out of surgery. It's just tiring to be having all that compression on, like, fitted on me and stuff like that. So, yeah,
But I got my other two dropped off, and I'll be getting them back tomorrow. And so I'll be happy that I can switch these out. But so this little concoction I done put together right here is my little ratchet way of basically not trying to buy Faja so fast because your body be shrinking and shit like that. So therefore, I was just trying to find different ways. And this abdominal wrap that I did buy when I had got my supplies, I'm going to say you definitely would need that. Like, it definitely helps, and I would definitely say that you should get one if you plan on having surgery. I also have like a waistband that I had before, and I just wrapped it around. But I basically wrap myself and wrap my boys inside, and I have this all inside of my Faja. And this is just to keep tight compression, and I just, you know, wearing my Faja like an outside suit at this point. But I will eventually get another one, but this does work. So, excuse my bra. I got my tape and done and everything pushing up on it, but anyway, excuse that. But yeah, so I got me a little new, little cheap little Faja for Amazon. Well, let me not say cheap, but it was about $30-$40, and I've been paying like $100 and something, which they was all worth it though. I can't say that. This material is more stretchy, and I wouldn't say advise these types like in your beginning stages of surgery anyway. So definitely get the ones with the rough material. They gonna cost some money, the different material. But yeah, so I got a large in this. I got my boys and everything in. Y'all, please say hello to Papa, because he's making it known that he's right there. I'm going to show the video, well, a little picture I got of what the name is. But this is the name. I'm going to get it taken in the waist, because I'm having issues with Fajas because my thigh and butt ratio is way bigger than my waist. Mind you, I got a lot of stuff on, so really can't even tell the effects. Sometimes you can, some people can, but I'm about to take this off. But yeah, it's like real, it really needs to be tight.
Again, my apologies about the tag. I was trying to show it, didn't work out. But the Faja is called Yavanna. It's on Amazon. It's not hard to find at all. It's a very popular one, and if you need to be directed to it, I got you. Just let me know. But I did want to let you know that this clip and the one after this clip are my most recent body videos. These were taken in September. Most of these clips that's in this video was done right after my surgery. I'm just late with getting them to you guys. I'm just late with editing them. Like, these videos are about 4 or 5 months ago. But this clip and the one after, I will repeat, is my most recent. At this point, I am still doing fruit fasting, and I'm trying to shy away from chicken sometimes. I just have certain weeks where I do it. Y'all just got to bear with me. That's how I'm doing it, and that's how I'm going to keep doing it. But if you do want to compare, this is the same Faja that I had in the last clip, but this is kind of months after the fact. And yes, I'm still doing the abdominal wrap and wraps under.
So this is my durable Faja. This is like my second Faja that I got. It's my only long one that goes to my knees. No, I do not like the ones that go to my knees, but the ones that stop at your like thigh, they do kind of roll up. So this is a more convenient one when you don't want to be irritated all day. But it is loud. Like, this material, when you walk, you can hear it. Like, it is so loud. People at work be like, shh, 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 shh. But okay, so I do have on my boys' phones, my abdominal wrap, and my waistband. And I actually put it on and have to tuck it in like how I did when I first was in there. So I think that's kind of like a good thing. I just, you know, don't need to go ahead and buy one. And this is my abdominal wrap sticking out and stuff like that. So, yeah, that's just because of my button, whatever, coming off right there. But, yeah, so I'm about to try on pants. Yep, my dog is right here as usual. So I have some pants that I have not ever tried on ever since I had surgery. I have not even tried on a pair of pants. But these are like some khakis that I got. And I didn't really think they would fit, but I put them on. And these are like the biggest pants, like the more ones that I can say I felt like, instead of jeans, that these might kind of fit. So, y'all can see, they a little snug. These are the pockets right here. I might have to fix that or whatever. But I just wanted to see. I'm kind of happy because I've been wanting to wear some pants by now, bro. I've been wearing like little tights and skirts and dresses like since I had surgery. So like I like this or whatever. It do button up. I'm just having a hard time with buttons. Crazy. But yeah. So it's like a perfect fit too. Just wanted to say, I got me some little pants.
It's fucked up, you up in the E, gave you everything you need, and you turn your back on me, you don't know.
Yelling out, we ain't selling out, we got money, but we ain't lending out, we got bars, but we ain't billing out, and that pink Ferrari, we peeling out. I told Tay, bring the Bob Dylan out, that pussy so cold, we just chilling out, baby, yelling, yelling, yelling out. It's Barbie, bitch, if you still in doubt. And I'm about like.
Get that money, man. I got this shit from Dolph. It ain't no nigga. They talk about you when you got a name. That's the game. Soon as you get.
When the hoods done got the same punches on you, I'm busted on you. No, I'm busted on you. Hit game cold, put an office on you.
I won't waste no time. I won't waste my time. Put it down to you. Put my pride aside. Give it all to you.
Ain't no bitch finna front on me. Bad body bitch with a jumbo teeth. Yell, I'ma get it like a bumblebee. Girl, nobody listen to you, listen talking about me. It's always a bird trying to teach shit. You offended when I be on defense. That's who worry about me and my nigga. You should worry about the nigga you're sleep with. Faith is given and never not gave. Been to Atlanta, but bitches ain't brave. Hot bitches mad, I'm the number one pick. It's funny, your nigga the one that's a trade. Bitches is mad, stupid. They get to the bag and lose it. I'm still in the bed, I live on her head. Water and gas included. Bitches don't wanna go Birkin for Birkin. Bitches ain't got enough hits for a versus. Bitches be acting so different in person. Cardio friends, I can see where she nervous. This shit is a circus, I'm dipping detergent. I'm sick of the nurses, my whip got the crack.
Love at first sight, girl, when you walked in.
I love staring at my bitch, she gorgeous. She loves staring at my kid, it's gorgeous.